Skipper, this is Morton.
Go ahead, Chip.
We're just off Manhattan Island at periscope depth. Trim satisfactory, waiting further orders.
Very well. Admiral Nelson and I will be right there.
Aye, aye, Chip.
Flying service checked out and ready to launch, sir.
Very well, Chief. Carry on.
Aye, aye, sir. Go ahead, Lee. I'll be right with you.
Right.
One last reminder, Chip. We'll be gone no more than an hour, and don't surface for any reason during that time. It's vital that our presence in New York is not known. Any questions?
No, sir. We'll be waiting for you.
Right.
Stand by, ready to launch.
Aye, aye, sir.
Underwater all the way in?
All the way to the pier. We can't afford to attract any attention.
Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Launch.
Chief? Any word yet, sir?
No, nothing.
Well, he'd been gone over an hour by now.
They expected to be. We won't be hearing anything. They're keeping radio silence.
Why did this operation have to be so hush-hush?
I guess the Admiral had his reasons.
Yeah, I guess so. Anyway, they ought to be back pretty soon. Don't you think?
Almost any minute, I hope.
Yes, and me too. Do you think anyone saw us bringing it aboard?
You better pray if they didn't.
One of the curators at the museum said that the body in there is over 3,000 years old.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, secure this one. What's the matter?
Nothing. I have fine.
Yeah. I'll do this. Yeah, you better strap yourself in. Got to get back to Seaview.
Lee. Lee. suddenly I got dizzy. I guess I passed out.
We'll have Doc look you over when we get back aboard.
Oh, I'm okay now. It's all right.
Just going to be sure.
Sick bay and have Doc look him over. Chief, take a detail and unload the cargo we brought in. I want it safely stowed in the main stores locker.
Aye, sir.
Chief, get us underway.
Of course.
Due east. Now get moving.
Aye, sir.
Well, you live.
Here, take this.
What is it?
It's a mild sedative.
Go on, take it. It's not going to put you to sleep. Just relax your nerves a bit. There's nothing wrong with my nerves.
Take it. That's better. Admiral, this is sick bay.
Yes, Doc, how is he?
Physically, he's in excellent shape. But there is some indication of a nervous disorder. Nothing serious, but rest is definitely indicated.
Hmm. You're sure about that? There's nothing serious?
Yes, quite sure. But I do recommend that he go to bed at once and that tomorrow he be placed on light duty.
Admiral, I feel great. I'm perfectly fit for duty.
Lee, listen to me. Doc is here to make exactly those decisions now. Suppose we let him do his job.
All right, sir. I'll go to my cabin and I'll hit the sack right now.
All right, we'll see how things look in the morning. This is the Admiral. Have Mr. Morton report to my cabin immediately.
Aye, aye, sir.
Well, that's pretty close figuring, sir. Even if we run at full speed all the way, we can barely meet the schedule on time.
And then run at full speed. Chip, from now until further notice, you're acting captain of this ship. That's why I think you should understand how vital this mission is.
Aye, sir.
Well, if you've been following the news, you know that there's a great deal of unrest in the Middle East. It might erupt into shooting war at any moment. That's why the State Department has asked us to take over this mission.
The mission has something to do with the box you and the skipper brought aboard from New York.
It has everything to do with it. The box, as you call it, is a national treasure belonging to one of the countries involved in this crisis.
Well, if it's a national treasure of the Middle East, how did it get to New York?
Well, it was discovered by American archaeologists about 70 years ago and brought to a museum in New York. But when a new government took over, they started a crusade to recover their national treasures.
And the mummy is one of them, huh?
Right. Now, State feels if it can be returned at exactly the right moment, it might help to prevent the war.
And when is exactly the right time?
When the cabinet meets in emergency session in about 70 hours.
Why all the secrecy, sir?
Because there are factions that would like to provoke the war, that would do anything within their power to prevent us from delivering this cargo.
Do they know we have it aboard?
That's the big question. If they do, it won't be long before we know about it. Now, Chip, I'm depending on you to deliver this cargo. And you'll go down time. That's all.
Thank you.
Admiral, this is Morton.
Yes, Chip, go ahead.
I'm going off watch now. I just checked the main stores locker. Everything's ship-shaped down there.
About the navigation report?
Right on the button. All departments reporting normal operations. Any special orders for the night?
No, everything seems to be under control. Go to bed, get a good night's sleep.
Aye, aye, sir. Good night.
Good night, Chip.
Hurry up, will you? A fuse or something?
No, they're all right. Any of those players? Mac.
From one of the guys who helped unload it. Now, that box in the main store's locker is a mummy case, and there's a mummy inside.
A mummy, big deal. How long's it been dead?
Well, I hear like 3,000 years.
Okay, then it's real dead. Can't do us any harm.
I know, but I've always heard that mummies are in bad luck.
Oh, come on, Ski. Come on. Don't tell me you believe in bad luck.
Well, not exactly. I just don't like to take chances, that's all.
Come on, now, that's superstition. Forget it. If something's been dead for 3,000 years, it can't hurt anybody. You know, that's the trouble with this ship. You can't find any wood to knock on. Come on, let's hit the hay.
Intruder.
Yes.
Easy. Oh. That dizziness again.
Who are you firing at?
Firing?
It's nearly a full clip fired.
I don't remember firing a shot.
Better get back into bed.
No, I'm all right now.
Sure, you're fine. Why don't you just lie down?
Come on, Skipper. Off your feet.
Gonna be all right?
Sure he will be after a good night's sleep.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's get out of here and see that he gets one.
Thank you. control?
According to our speed tapes, we're making excellent time.
Where does this put us now?
Just about here.
Well, that's even better than I hoped.
Hey, Chief. Something wrong?
This is our position. Take a look.
Well, this has got to be a mistake.
How many times is this computer wrong?
At this rate, we should be about here this time tomorrow morning.
Mm-hmm. That's a good 3 hours ahead of schedule.
Mr. Morton, take a look at this.
Well, this is impossible. There must be some error.
Sir, how many times is that computer wrong?
Let me sit down.
How did this happen? I don't know, sir, but we've lost a good 10 hours. Our position now is back here.
There's only one thing that can explain that.
I did, sir, in Mr. Morton's order.
Are these the figures?
No, sir, nothing like the ones I used. How did this happen, sir?
There's only one way, Chief. Somebody deliberately altered the settings to put us off course. Somebody right here aboard this ship.
Admiral, this is Morton. Sparks has just received a top priority message for you from the State Department.
I'll be right there.
Aye, sir.
That's all we need.
Bad news, sir?
Well, the emergency cabinet meeting has been called 12 hours sooner. That means our deadline is 12 hours earlier.
12 hours? Well, there's absolutely no way we can make up that amount of time.
No, but there's a way. The flying's up.
What about the matter of secrecy?
Well, we've got to make some kind of a sacrifice, and we can't afford to be late. Now get the flying sub ready at once.
Chief.
Sir.
Ready the flying sub for immediate launch.
Aye, sir.
Well, I was just going to order the sarcophagus loaded onto the flying sub.
I know, but I'd rather you waited until the last possible moment.
Any particular reason?
If someone aboard this ship is working against us, I'd like to give them as little advance information as possible.
Flying sub.
Simpson, he's dead.
Simpson. And I'm very sorry to hear about that. How'd it happen?
I don't know, sir, but we're investigating it.
And the wreck controls?
Well, they're still being repaired, but there's no telling how long it'll take. We'll never make that deadline now.
No. And I agree.
I don't.
What are you doing on your feet?
Well, I was getting a little tired of being useless, Admiral. I thought I could help. Looks like you could use a little.
I'm afraid it's no use, Lee. We're more than 24 hours off schedule, and the flying sub's laid up. There's no way we can make that deadline.
He's right, Lee. We can't make it.
I think we can. It'll be close, but there's a chance.
How?
By running at flank speed the rest of the way.
We can't do that. The engines will never take it.
We've never run half that long at flank speed.
Then it looks like we're about to set a new record. That is, if I'm still in command of the ship.
Yes, you are.
Engineering?
Engineering, aye.
And this is the captain. Come to flank speed. Hold her wide open until further orders.
Aye, aye, sir.
Chip, How did we get so far off course?
Somebody tampered with the automatic navigator.
So far we don't know who.
Master at Arms.
Security, aye.
I want armed guards posted at all vital areas in the ship. Maintain around-the-clock details.
Aye, aye, sir.
Well, welcome back to duty.
Everything all right in this section?
So far, so good. You feeling any better, sir?
No, I'm feeling fine. Now, just make sure that the guards stay on their toes, all right?
You can count on that.
Very well. Carry on.
Aye, aye, sir.
Chief Sharkey, get some Commandant of the main storage locker on the double.
Aye, aye.
Breathing and pulse are normal, huh? I think he's gonna be all right. Don't move him now.
Aye, sir.
Who could have attacked him? Who? Who or what? Topside to find out. Take care of him until the corpsman get here.
Aye, sir.
I want a full report on all damage as soon as possible. And get me a casualty list.
Aye, aye, sir.
Now, hear this. We're on the bottom, but we've been lucky. The depth is under 500 feet. That means divers can work outside. Now, we have every chance in the world of patching up the hull and getting out of here. So turn to and police up the place.
Still holding, so we're tight and dry.
Can we get a diving party on?
I've already given the order.
Good, good. I'm going to sit there. We got ourselves quite a casualty list. Come, carry on.
Aye, aye, sir.
Chief Sharkey.
Go ahead, Chief.
The diving party's on its way out to make repairs on the hull, sir.
Very well. Keep me informed.
Aye, aye, sir.
It's a pretty strange group of casualties you sent me.
Strange? The strange in what way?
Well, Blair. He's the man who was standing guard at the circuitry room. He has a bad bruise on the back of his neck.
The back of his neck? Well, how could he get that in the fall?
He couldn't. That's what's so strange. Looks to me like someone hit him.
Well, how is it now?
As soon as he gets rid of a headache, he'll be ready for duty.
All right. Good. Now, Kowalski.
That's another strange case. If he had a broken arm, I'd know how to treat him. But I can't find anything wrong except a pure shock syndrome.
Well, that's the same diagnosis you made about Captain Crane.
That's right. The cases seem to be identical.
Well, how are they now?
They're both coming out of it nicely. Nothing wrong with either one that a good, sound night's sleep won't cure.
Look, you said that before about Captain Crane, and this is his third attack.
Yes, I know. Well, as I said, a broken arm would be much simpler.
All right. As soon as the captain's on his feet, have him come down to my office.
Right.
Back aboard, sir.
What's the report?
Hull patch, we can get off the bottom anytime you say, sir.
That's fine. Tell them well done.
Aye, aye, sir.
Control room. The flying sub repair party has completed its work and the craft is ready for service.
Very well. Secure the detail.
Aye, sir.
Admiral, this is Morton.
Go ahead, Chip.
It seems our luck is beginning to change, sir. Repair work's completed and we can get underway.
Good. Take us up.
Aye, aye, sir. Maneuvering, make all preparations to surface.
Aye, sir.
I had no idea all that happened. I was checking the guard details when I suddenly blacked out. Next thing I knew, I woke up in sick bay. What do you think's wrong with me, Admiral?
I don't know, Lee. Neither does Doc. We can't afford to take any more chances with your health. That's why I'm relieving you of all duty until we reach port.
Well, that's not necessary. I'm all right now.
Look, I said I don't want to take any more chances.
You think I'm going to have another attack, don't you?
Well, it's a possibility. Look, I want you to get a good rest, that's all.
Now, what about the mission?
Oh, I'm not concerned about completing it.
Not concerned? You tell me yourself there isn't a prayer of reaching port before the deadline.
I have no intention of reaching it by then. I'm taking the sarcophagus and the flying sub.
Well, what about your orders?
I have an okay to change them. They would have preferred a less spectacular way, but any method's better than none. I'll fly out tomorrow morning.
I see.
So there's really no reason why you can't take the next couple of days off.
Now, do me a favor, will you? Get some rest. Right.
Yes, Admiral.
I'm in the observation nose. Why are the crash doors closed?
Engineering recommended it until we could find out how weak in the forward frames are.
Do you want me to open them?
No.
No, that's not necessary.
My eyes, sir.
So he's got a beautiful bruise on his cheek. What happened?
He had another one of his attacks. He must have fallen.
Well, we'll get him up to sick bay.
Yeah, do that. And give him a sedative, will you? Stiff one. Enough to knock him out for about 24 hours.
All right, men, let's get him up to sick bay.
Our exact position?
I just checked it out, sir. As you can see for yourself, we can't possibly make it now.
Oh, yes, we can. I'm going on the flying sub.
When, sir?
As soon as it's ready for launch. See to it, will you?
Aye, aye.
Admiral! What is it? What's the matter, Chief?
That thing. It's alive, sir.
Get hold of yourself, Chief.
Well, now, let him talk.
It kept coming after me, sir. It's on its way up here.
Sound general quarters, close all quarters.
Battle stations, battle stations.
The watertight doors are slowing down.
Believe me, sir, it won't do any good. It'll take an atom bomb to stop it.
Atom bomb? You have an idea of that, Chief. No, where is it? How much time do we have?
I don't know, sir, but not much. It just kept coming after me, sir.
Reactor room emergency.
Reactor room, aye.
This is Nelson. Now listen carefully. We're coming right down there. Stand by to channel the entire output of the reactor through the starboard hull cable. All of it.
Aye, sir. Standing by.
Ship, bring out a coil of number 4 cable and meet me at the door of the reactor room on the double.
Aye.
Yeah. check out the reactor.
I got you.
Chip, hurry up with the cable.
She's all set, sir.
Sarcophagus and stow it aboard the flying cell. One sacred sarcophagus, signed for, sealed, and delivered. I think the crisis is over.
Congratulations. I'm afraid that wasn't much help.
Well, it wasn't your fault. How do you feel?
I'm much better, thanks. At least for the time being. What if I get another attack?
You won't. We've taken care of it.
It must have exerted some sort of control over my mind.
Definitely.
How do you explain it?
You know, Lee, I think there are some things that are better left unexplained, huh?